Today we have with us Mr. Tanmay Jyot from Flipkart Bangalore. So we came to know that the Flipkart has conducted basically some internal innovation competition and where his team won the prize. So we just caught hold of him, he was here. And
I'll tell you something about UX as a profession and what we do at Flipkart. I hope everyone here is, I think, from computer science stream. So you might be coding, I get coders, yeah. So our work comes prior to coding. We work with project managers and conceptualize the product. And after our product is confirmed, then it goes to the development stage where coding starts. So I'll tell you something about UX and how it affects the company. I'm presently an interaction designer at Flipkart. I have an experience of 6 years, basically in design only. Textile engineering from MSU over here, and then directly went into design sector from NID. And after that, I'm working. First 3 years were freelance, and then I joined Bangalore companies. So in terms of digital systems, I think Bangalore is the best place. So all the students over here, I mean, if you want a career growth which is really fast, I think you should look at Bangalore as your start zone rather than any of the other places. Because over there are so many companies. What was happening 10 years before was that a product manager used to conceptualize a product, and then coders used to code and develop that product into a software. After what happened was there was a disconnect between the actual users who were using the product and the coders that were coding it. So this user experience actually becomes a bridge. What we do is we do a lot of research. Research is something which we understand the people. We do research like how people are buying. What is going on in their mind when they are actually selecting a product? What kind of comparison they do? So our marketing team, they go to different states, different cities, and they conduct these small user group studies, and they try to understand how people shop. All this thing comes to us as a report, and such is an integral part of design right now. Then it goes to interaction design. Interaction design means making wireframes. Before a software is developed, we make a wireframe. Here is a wireframe. It's a working prototype. You can click and it will go somewhere else. So this is our deliverable. This goes to the developers, and developers then code and make this into a real website or an app. We create processes and flows, and then different use case scenarios are jotted down. Like for example, a user is signed in, then what he should see. If he signed out, then what kind of things he should see. All those things, we design those things. This is the whole process of how a product is conceptualized and delivered. So it starts with discovery. Discovery is planning of a feature. So mostly the discovery part is done by the MBA, all the MBA people in most of the companies. So what they do is they take a product, they see the market feasibility, they check for businesses, how viable the product is, how much revenue can be generated by this. We want to sell books to the user. This is what they tell us. How to sell it, how to make that is our responsibility, my team's responsibility. So then in design phase, what we do is we do research, we do wireframing, prototyping, all the usability studies, all those things. I'll go into detail in a bit. After that, it goes to the software developers, like programmers. They do programming, they do testing, they check for parity on different devices. So for example, we are having iOS, Android, Windows Phone, Web, and AmpSite. So all the five pieces, everything should work similarly. If a person is using an iOS device and he starts using website, he should understand that how to use that particular website or how to buy, or if you want to track your order, where should you go. So that's why there should be a parity between everything. And last comes the deploy phase, where quality check happens, all the bug fixing happens, A/B testing happens, maintenance, everything is happened. So before something goes live and everyone else can see, we have internal servers where we check everything, we load test it, we do hacking test, people try to hack the site themselves and make it hacker proof, and then only it goes outside. So first we get a brief like this, what is required by division. Then we do analysis of that. Okay, presently what is the problem in the system? Why do we want to change it? All those kind of questions are asked. We make a report out of it. This helps in our designing process. After this, we do a bit of computer analysis. For example, Amazon is there. So what Amazon is doing right now? What Snapdeal is doing right now? What new are we going to give to the people? All those things comes at this stage. That are we going to improve the quality? Are we going to help the user if we give this new feature? Then we do user task analysis, that from when a user logs in to the time he purchases and checks out, what are the steps he is going to go through and how can we minimize those steps? If you want to buy a phone and if it takes more than 10-15 clicks, then it's a wastage of your time, it's a wastage of our bandwidth also. So we need to minimize that. So how fast we can get your product and how fast we can kind of let you purchase that product, all those things come into this user task analysis. After that, we do a hierarchy. So in a website, certain things are very important and certain things are like you can keep it below the fold. So we try to understand that what will a user want? What will a user want to see first when he comes onto this page? And then what all things are like complementary to all those buying behaviors? So here the book cover will be coming. So it will be an image. So according to studies, we know that whenever someone opens this page, the first thing you guys are going to see is that cover image, because it will be the most attractive thing. So then after that, all the things which is going to influence your buying decision has to come near this thing. So that is why we keep the title over here, the rating, the price and the buy button. So all those things are the top things which are going to decide the buying behavior of a user. That is the reason it comes here. So everything that you see on this website is after some kind of research. We have done some research. Why this thing, this description should come here, why user review should come here, all those things is, it's not just kept without any thought process. There's a thought process involved into it, and that is done by the designer's interaction. After that, we make a low fidelity wireframes. This is just to, we need to communicate internally that what we are doing. Designers can talk among ourselves, but when we want to talk to an MBA, or if you want to talk to a software engineer, we need to try to show them what we are thinking. So we need to make some small sketches and show that, okay, the product image is going to come here, the title is going to come here, is it possible, is it feasible? Because many websites, they are in some grid structure. We cannot break that grid structure. So we need to talk with the software developers and understand that, okay, is this thing even feasible or not technically? And if it is not, then what will it take to change it? Rough wireframe. Now, this thing goes to the product managers. They can understand, okay, this is a banner over here. So they can monetize it. Advertisement might come over there. So what should be the size of it? How much money can we earn from all those things? And then we make a very high fidelity wireframe. So here, this is shared with the executive teams and everyone, so they can understand that how a web page is going to look like. Here most of the elements are placed. We have the categories, we have the books, we have titling, pricing information, other sections are there, then some advertisement will come, where it will be placed, all those things are kept here. Then this is again discussed internally with the company and other stakeholders. All the tests, it goes to the visual design. So this is the visual design. So after that, all the fonts, all the typography, color scheme, all those things are blended into it. Also, we do usability testing. So once we have a mock ready, we go to users and we give them like this web page and try to find a book that you like. So we give them a prototype and we try and test them. We see if they are able to search the book, if they are able to complete that task. If they are not able to do that, we again go to our drawing board, we change what all problems did they face. We again try to solve those things. So when we are making something for mass market, it is very essential to do user testing like this. So we can improve our designs day by day. This is an ongoing process actually. Then again, we also do adaptive designs, like when the same website goes to mobile, how it looks like, when it goes to tablet, how it looks like. And, we give this prototype to the software engineers, where they code it. So if it goes to an Android guy, then he'll use, I think, Java. If it goes to iOS guy, he will use C# or Objective-C. So we give this thing to all those developers and they themselves code it in different ways. So if they are making for website, they'll use that language. So the look and feel should be same, but the languages might be different. Then internally the tracking process happens, that what are the changes happening. If anything is not feasible with iOS, then it has to change. And if the change is major, then it happens on all the devices, like Android and Windows Phone also changes. All those things has to be kept in sync. Most of you guys are developers. So what happens in developing business is you start with one position as coders, then you go into second level, third level, then you might become an architect or you might become a manager. These are the two ways of going. So that is one career path that you can take. This is a new field right now. UX design is not very, it is just 4 or 5 years back this has started. Even the topmost colleges, there are only 5 different colleges which are actually giving this interaction design degrees. So you can understand, there are so many colleges which are giving engineering degrees, but there are very few colleges who are giving this design degree. So the demand is very high right now. Presently, it's very high. So if somebody wants to do a master's in designing, following are the design colleges in India. So these are the Indian colleges and these are some of the global top 10 colleges which give this kind of degrees. A bit about job market, because many students are here, I guess. So opportunities are worldwide. What I'm showing you here is something related to Bangalore. I don't know how the job market is over here, but every jump gets to 20-30% increment, and yearly 10% increment is normal over there. A fresher with this kind of UX design kind of thing has a salary of roughly 6 to 9 lakhs per annum. And the workload is very minimal because we are in a planning process, we are not in the execution process. Okay, but Flipkart, it has a valuation of 7 billion right now. The core team is around 3,000 people. This is what comprises of development. Any questions related to Bangalore, how the companies are there over? Like 24 years working is our demographic. We have a demographic module. So we only ask people who are 24 years of age, who are working, who are in middle class. So what happens is when we narrow down those things, the information that comes to us is more or less similar, on the similar lines. And we don't ask a very subjective question. We ask questions which can be quantified.